Kingsley Edwards, you're the CEO of Leetcoin. You're trying to do something pretty original and different with video games and Bitcoin. Can you tell me a little bit about what your goal is, kind of, to integrate Bitcoin into gaming and how it's different than other forays of Bitcoin into gaming?
So what we're doing, we're creating a kind of a competitive esports platform where gamers are going to be able to play against each other for Bitcoin. And what's kind of unique about our features is that you can, it kind of like, the easiest thing to like compare it to is almost like online poker, but applied to video games. So say we're going to be supporting League of Legends here in the next 2 weeks. So what's going to happen is, you know, gamers are going to be able to check out kind of our matchmaking lobby, and they'll be able to see, you know, all these games, or you can create your own game if you want. And from there, you know, other players will join, or you can have a team or team versus team, and you play. And then after the game is done, you kind of deposit into this game, right? Or, so this match, we verify the results, and then the Bitcoins are it's all automated, and the Bitcoins are paid out to basically the winners.
Nice.
So that's kind of like one way that we're doing it. Another way that we have it is, say, for like a game like a first-person shooter, where gamers can, they can go onto our platform or onto one of our servers, and we'll just take a game like Counter-Strike. So, you know, like the whole thing is like counter-terrorists versus terrorists. So we can actually do in-game rewards too. So if player one kills player two, well, Bitcoins could automatically be transferred from player two's account to player one's account for the kill. And then on top of that, we actually have it so that say if there's like a bomb planting map or something, so the terrorist plants the bomb, well, they get a reward for that, like a small reward, and then if the counter terrorist defuses the bomb, they can get a small reward for that as well. So there's like, there's kind of infinite possibilities as far as how our technology can like interact with games going forward. So that's what we're really excited about.
Yeah, I mean, I've been aware of Bitcoin for a couple of years now, and like one of the possibilities that I thought about just randomly before was, you know, you have a currency that can be transferred instantly between people and in very, very tiny divisible amounts. So, you know, what if you integrated that in a video game and have all the players, you know, have this, you know, constant fluctuating, you know, Bitcoin balances based on who kills who and stuff like that. That's basically what you guys are trying to create, right? With all these with different games, not just FPSs as well.
Yeah, correct. So right now we're focused on games, that popular games that already exist. But in the future, we really see our API being used with games that are being developed right now, or games that are being updated. So the game developer can actually take our API and you know, a certain like in-game action would trigger a reward or a microtransaction of any type.
Yeah, I mean, there's all kinds of possibilities, right? Not just people earning Bitcoin from people they kill, but maybe there's like a treasure chest on the map, and when they find that loot, they get, you know, an extra 0.01 Bitcoin or something like that. There's all kinds of ridiculous possibilities that developers can utilize and invent, really, by using your API.
Correct. Yeah. Now, I mean, just kind of what you were talking about, like a treasure chest or something like that. Totally possible. And then we also have like our promo servers, which will be back online soon, where, you know, players, they can go without any Bitcoin and they can play on our promo servers. And for each, say, if it's a FPS, they get a kill. Well, then they get, you know, like 1,000 or 10,000 Satoshi or something like that. So then, you know, our whole kind of goal with that is to not only promote Bitcoin in the gaming space, gets you know, these larger companies online, maybe a Bitcoin miner or something like that, you know.
Yeah,
now people can kind of like mine for Bitcoin just by playing video games, and it helps the players get associated with Bitcoin and get comfortable with Bitcoin and also with our platform. So it's like we consider it like a win-win-win.
Yeah. So how do you guys plan to combat cheaters when there's money incentives involved? Now there's probably going to be a huge target for cheaters to go on there and try and game the system. How are you going to try and prevent that?
Yeah, so with League of Legends, we're not so worried about that. That game is pretty fail safe as far as cheaters and hackers. There's not really a way to game the system. With games like Counter-Strike and well, especially the older Counter-Strikes, they're kind of notorious for that. And then, but the newer ones, a little less. So what we're doing, we're having as many like anti-cheat and hacking software, third-party stuff, and also stuff that's from the game developer on our servers. So that's always like kind of a thing that's that of course there's money involved, right? So there's always people that's going to try to game the system. So we're just our goal is just try to be one step ahead of those people.
So this is just for computer games right now, is that correct?
Yeah, right now we're focused on the PC games, and then going forward we'll step into mobile and then eventually console.
That would be really fascinating if you guys get on the consoles as well, and people can, like, Destiny just came out for the next gen consoles, and like that's a, like a kind of an MMO FPS like hybrid kind of thing. That would be pretty crazy if people can kill each other for bitcoins and then find bitcoin loot on the map and, raid bases and get bitcoin prizes from there. But like how, I mean, if there's like not just PvP, but like if there's bitcoin loot on the map, what are some possible like ways to fund that? Like who would fund the loot on the map that doesn't come from any particular player? Would that come from the game developer or maybe the community themselves who want to like build up a big prize for this one tournament or something. I mean, what are the possibilities?
Yeah, those two they just mentioned would be good, just straight from the game developer, or yeah, from kind of a crowdfunded community source. Another thing that we're talking about is getting either like even with matches or servers where they're sponsored by like I said, could be Bitcoin mining companies, could be larger game developers, could be anybody that just wants to like advertise, could be Coke Esports that wants to bring people onto these servers where they can make a small amount of Bitcoin, but it's something, and then they can use that further on our platform. So yeah, kind of just right now, like we're just focused on these. Like I said, we're focused on a few games and a few ways that we can interact. But the future is kind of infinite possibilities.
Yeah, it's really, really wide open. There's so many possibilities with cryptocurrencies, especially in it applied to gaming. I mean, so far, basically, we've just seen very minimal excursions of Bitcoin integration into gaming. We've seen seals with clubs. You can bet with small amounts of Bitcoin or large amounts if you want in Texas Hold'em. I believe you can tip people on Twitch.tv now, people, gamers you're watching, and just tip the performers who are performing games for you. But no one's really done this before where you can have direct competitive micro rewards between players themselves within games. So it's really, really exciting, and I'm glad to see you guys kind of going after popular games first, like League of Legends. My 17-year-old brother plays League of Legends, and he's not really involved in Bitcoin yet, but maybe this can get him into it, maybe if he thinks he's pretty good enough to win against people and earn some extra Bitcoin.
Yeah, exactly. So, and it just why we're kind of going the PC route first. Well, first we have our two like closest competitors. We have one that is actually focused on mobile, and we have one that actually already does console. None of them do cryptocurrency, and also the games that they support are kind of like lacking. They're not on like the grand scale of League of Legends. So. The PC kind of esports competitive environment is—it's really getting bigger and bigger. So we want to take advantage of that. So if we can just get a small portion of that, even like a tenth of a percent or 1%, that's really huge, not only for us but for Bitcoin too.
So there's probably a lot of challenges involved in trying to create something like this. I want to touch on two separate t challenges that you guys might run into. First of all, legal challenges. You guys aren't available in what, 17 states right now because of what, gambling regulations? Are you guys classified as a gambling service, and is that why you're not available in the whole United States?
Yeah, so we're available in 37 out of the 50 states. So yeah, the reason why that is because some states they don't kind of differentiate skill-based gaming, which is what we are, where you're putting money towards your own skills against another person
Right.
and their own skills. So there's very little to no chance involved with it. And unlike other kind of Bitcoin gambling sites or whatever, or wagering sites, we're trying to, we're dealing with now, or we want to be dealing with, going forward, large game developers that are, large corporations. So we want to make sure that our T's are crossed and our I's are dotted. And so we do work with a attorney group out of Boston, and
That's good.
they're worldwide to make sure that that happens.
So the other separate challenge that you guys are probably running into is just pure technical challenges. Like, how hard is it to create an API like this that pulls data from the game servers and analyzes it and basically doles out rewards based on who's winning and who's losing? Are there technical challenges associated with that that you guys ran into?
So right now, as we just try to, focus on very popular games that are already in existence, there are some challenges. We're more dependent on that game developer. But going forward, that's the whole reason why we created our API, instead of just focusing on just su supporting a or building our platform just based on like one game. So that going forward, game developers, once we do have some traction, game developers will just pick up our API, and it's a win for them too, because in our API they can actually monetize their games. So they can give away their games, for free, and make more money potentially off the back end than the front end of
Yeah.
selling it for $5, $10, $20. So there is that built-in mechanism in our API where game developers can take whatever, fee they see reasonable for them.
Yeah. It's like game developers have never really thought about possibilities like this before because it's never been possible before. Like game developers, in past few years they've thought of new ways to make money through like DLC and micro payments and stuff like that. Oh, pay a dollar for, 500 extra coins or whatever in your mobile game. Like this can open up a world of new possibilities for developers. Yeah, to make money off their games. Do you guys have a release date for like the API itself for all developers? Like, is there a time frame for when that's going to be available?
Actually our API is available already. So right now we haven't been, really pushing it out there yet. We've just really been focused on getting League of Legends supported, because we feel like they're right now they are the kind of the king of all games. So we feel that once we tackle this one, get some traction, get some matches, and a lot of a pretty decent user base. From there, we'll be able to use that as leverage and reach out to other game developers,
Oh yeah.
and just go from there and just build on top until we have every popular game supported.
Is there anything else you want to add about this and about Leetcoin and what you guys are doing?
I don't think we covered how we came up with the concept.
Yeah. Let's get into that. How did
Okay.
you guys do it, and what was your motivation?
So it actually happened where I was actually just talking with a friend over Skype or something, or Google Hangouts or something, and he was showing me, we were both getting into Bitcoin, and this was early last year, and he was showing me this game, Minecraft, and someone had built this Bitcoin casino in Minecraft. It was called Bit Vegas. And I grew up in Vegas. I went to middle school and high school in Vegas. Actually, I'm here right now. But so I've kind of always, lived in, or dealt with the gambling world and the casino world. And so this is all like very interesting to me. Like, oh, now I can be in a video game, and I can play, casino games in this video game, kind of like The Sims, a little bit,
Yeah.
but for Vegas. But then kind of the aha moment came on. It's like, okay, but wait a second, I'm playing a video game, which are great, but I'm still playing in the video game, I'm still playing regular casino games.
Right.
So why can't the actual video game itself have that kind of competitive, wagering kind of mentality going on, where player versus player? So from there I was like, well, let's see, what game do I like that maybe we can test this with? And so I picked Counter-Strike. I did some just small tests on with just the Reddit community, Bitcoin subreddit, and from there we've kind of evolved into this, and we're hoping to get, or we're going to be supporting, League of Legends and Counter-Strike, Go, Source, and TF2.
Yeah.
So
Yeah,
But it
nice.
just made sense. And we feel that, you know, the more we looked into actual esports as well, these tournaments are, bigger and bigger as the years go. A few months ago, we had a Dota 2 tournament, which is another kind of the same League of Legends type of game, a MOBA. And they had a cash prize pool of over $11 million. So we're getting into like
Jeez.
the World Series of Poker, like levels of, of money being thrown around.
Here's a question that I have. Like, if players go on there and they load their Bitcoin accounts with this and they go on and they're playing against people, and like let's say they're not very good and they get killed a lot, you know, and they lose their money, like is that going to discourage some people? Is it just going to be people going on who are like super confident in their abilities, trying to win money? Like, what's I don't know how quickly this could catch on in the community. Like, there's gonna be people going on and trying to get rich quick, and you know, I'm gonna kill a lot of people, get a lot of money, but then there's gonna be a lot of people as well who do that and get killed themselves a lot and lose their money. So yeah, I guess that's my point.
Okay. Yeah. So we've thought about that. So, and just going back to like online poker. So there's like kind of a natural, almost like a, I don't know what you want to call it, like a free market kind of mechanism that takes place in these types of environments where usually the less skilled players, they'll play for less money, and the higher skilled players, they'll play for more money. It just, makes sense. You're going to have, some higher skilled players are going to waste their time and just, destroy a lot of, people, but then they can actually make more money trying to beat other high skilled players for more money. And vice versa, you're going to have, noobs playing for a lot of money sometimes, just losing. But I see the majority of people are going to kind of fit in that category where, like I said, the less skilled players playing for less money, more skilled players playing for more.
Gotcha. Yeah.
Another thing about it is that obviously with Bitcoin, we can do, we the lowest you can play for like on our platform, we can set it to whatever, but right now it's just set to like 100 Satoshi, which is like
Wow, that's
something like
tiny.
a thousandth of a cent, right, or something like that. So you can still like kind of put money on the line without it being much money at all,
Yeah.
but it still adds that like element of like, oh, I'm still winning something, I'm still winning even if it's 10 cents or 50 cents or something like that. Like I'm still winning something. It makes the game even that more enjoyable. And kind of just like where you're just like, it adds that like competitive edge. And that's kind of also what we're providing for these game developers too, where it's just another way to attract that competitive player base to their games.
Yeah. Have you considered integrating other cryptocurrencies besides Bitcoin? Maybe like Dogecoin or something like that?
Yeah, in the future we want to take on as many currencies as possible. So even cryptocurrencies and even just regular currencies too. The whole point of our platform is to obviously we're Bitcoin believers and we're launching with just Bitcoin. But we want to bring the mass or help bring the masses to cryptocurrencies. So potentially, like I said, we might eventually offer ways to support fiat as well.
Yeah, nice. You'd probably have to like get banking relationships or something, right? Like, I mean, getting bank
Yeah,
transfer and stuff.
there's a lot more lot more required on the back end.
So yeah, I guess we can close this out. Thanks for joining me. And like people watching, like if they want to help out or maybe even like apply for a position with you guys, like what kind of like positions are you looking to fill? What kind of help do you need for this project?
So we're looking for developers, front ends, specifically Angular developers for front end stuff, and Python developers for back end.
Nice. Okay.
So, but and then they can reach out to us at admin@leetcoin.com.
Great. Cool. Okay. Yeah. Good luck with the League of Legends launch. It's going to be pretty exciting to see people, you know, betting money directly on a video game for the first time. So yeah. Thanks for joining me, Kingsley.
Yeah, thanks for having me.